makers of Bisquick and Crustquick present Bride and Groom.
The honor of your presence is requested at the wedding of Miss Margaret Ann Westfall and Mr. Frank Edward Stanevich.
Hello, and welcome to Bride and Groom. Today, we're going to meet two young people from West Virginia who started going steady from their very first date. After all the usual problems, plus some very unusual ones, such as being snowbound, they'll finally reach a happy ending to their love story when they're married by the Reverend Herbert C. Greenland, and we're going to meet them in just a moment, attend their wedding. But first, you know there's something that I know quite a bit about, and that is that new husbands and old ones like me like good food. So I ask an expert from Betty Crocker's kitchen just what kind of a kitchen talk she'd give a brand new bride. And she says that one of her very first suggestions would be Crustquick, the Betty Crocker pie crust mix. Because you make your pie country style with Crustquick, country style with deep and rich and flaky crust. Boy, look at that. And it's tender as it looks, too. Make my pie country style with Crustquick anytime. And look how easy. See how quick with Crustquick. No big sift and fuss. All you measure is the water. Just pour it in and stir it up. No guessing and messing. And look, you don't even cut in shortening. You just simply stir. This dough handles and rolls out easier, too, than the kind made the old-fashioned way with all those separate makings. Result? 4 minutes to the pie pan. Yep, this young lady timed herself. 4 minutes. That's why Crustquick makes good kitchen talk for you, too. And look at what you get. Come on up close there. Now, look at that crust. Flake on flake. It's just as rich and tender as it looks. See how flaky your crust can be with Crustquick. Now, when you use Crustquick, you're using Betty Crocker's recipe for perfect pie crust. So why do it long when you can do it short, hmm? Get your package of Betty Crocker's pie crust mix. 4 minutes to the pie pan. Make your next pie country style with Crustquick. Crustquick. And now I'd like you to meet our lovely bride. She's Miss Margaret Ann Westfall, and her bridegroom is Mr. Frank Edward Stanevich. Is that correct? An unusual name. Margaret, tell us about you, please.
I'm 20 years old, and I'm from a farming community in Flatwoods, West Virginia. I'm studying art and home economics, and junior in college. Mm-hmm. I have 5 brothers and 2 sisters.
Good-sized family. How about you, Frank?
I'm 21, and I come from a coal mining community of Sumley, West Virginia. At present time, I'm attending Glenville State College and studying for a teaching profession.
I'm supposed to be proud of Frank because he's a senior of his, president of his senior class.
Good.
And he's chosen as a member into Who's Who in American colleges and universities.
That's quite an honor. I'm very happy to hear. You both are attending Glenville State. Now, this is, sounds like a college romance, is it, Margaret?
Yes, I sort of noticed Frank at the beginning of school. So did some of the other girls.
Oh.
Broad shoulders, nice looking. And he was nice, but I didn't think I had a chance with him.
You like to, but you didn't know. Well, how did you finally meet Frank?
Well, we finally met at a basketball game. This was in February 1950. And the game was pretty close, and of course the band was there playing, and the drums were beating. And all of a sudden, I felt someone beating out the rhythm of the drums on my back. And of course, when I turned around, there was Margaret.
Right on your back. Were you kind of mad at her?
Well, no, I couldn't be. The big grin she had on her face there.
Oh, sure. Well, what started, that started your conversation, this...
Yes.
Turning around, you started talking.
Conversation there, and I walked her to the dorm after the game, but since she was going with another fella, I didn't ask for a date that night.
Oh.
However, at the next basketball game, I anticipated her arrival, and I more or less spread over to save her room there, leave the vacancy.
So she'd have a chance to sit by you.
That's correct. Mm-hmm. And we began our conversation again, and of course, this time when I walked her up, I did ask for a date.
Good. What happened to the other fellow, Margaret?
Well, we broke off. I didn't date any others after I started going with Frank. Neither did he. We just took it for granted we were going steady.
Nobody asked her anything. You just discovered you were going steady, huh? Did you remember when you knew you were falling in love, Margaret?
Well, we realized after we were going together that it was more than boyfriend and girlfriend romance.
Mm-hmm.
It was the last night of school that we really realized that we thought we would be separated for the summer.
Just the thought of it was enough to make you realize that this was more important. Well, when did you begin to talk about being married, Frank?
It was actually on the Thanksgiving vacation. That was 1950.
Mm-hmm.
And we went to my home, Margaret and my parents there. And we'd only planned to stay there over the weekend. But as it turned out, we had a snowstorm and stayed there for 10 days. It was actually at this time we began building our dreams together.
Being together and getting to know each other and all. And
she was the one for me then.
Mm-hmm. Did he propose to you then, Margaret?
No, he didn't. It happened that we were walking down, I've seen my ring before, but it happened we were walking down the streets window shopping, And Frank was trying to decide what to buy me for Christmas.
Oh.
And he would suggest a dress or a coat, but I'd always find something the matter with it. We passed the jewelry store, and Frank said, "Oh, I know what you want for Christmas." And I said, "Sure, I got my ring for Christmas, then."
Oh, my goodness. Then he proposed after that?
Yes, I made him propose before I would wear his ring.
Oh, I see. Remember what you said, Frank?
Well, wasn't much I could say then as far as getting out of the proposal. But I tried not to make it too formal, and that's more or less asking, "Well, shall we get married?"
What did you say, Margaret?
Oh, I said, I have to think it over.
And how long did you take?
About 2 seconds.
Oh, that's long enough for a girl to make up her mind. I'd like to meet your attendants, if I may, Margaret. And Frank, I thoroughly enjoyed that story. This young lady is...
My matron of honor, Mrs. Robert Westphal.
How do you do?
And this is my best man, Mr. Robert Westphal.
Oh, you're the bride's brother, is that right?
That's right.
Oh, we have for you these beautiful match keepsake matching rings, the exquisite diamond band with its 5 lovely diamonds so beautifully mounted, and the matching plain gold white gold keepsake band for the bride and groom, for your brother-in-law. And name your love song?
"Ah, Sweet Mystery of Life."
Okay, now as our bride and groom and their attendants leave for the ceremony, Phil Hanna sings their love song.
Sweet mystery of life, at last I found thee. Oh, I know at last the secret of it all. Oh, the longing, seeking, striving, waiting, yearning, the burning hopes, the idle joys and tears that fall.
Keep you only unto her, so long as you both shall live.
I will.
Margaret, will you take this man to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, and forsaking all others, keep you only unto him, so long as you both shall live?
I will.
You join your right hands together, please. I, Frank, take thee, Margaret.
I, Frank, take thee, Margaret.
To be my wedded wife.
Be my wedded wife.
From this time forward.
From this time forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
And thereto I pledge thee my faith.
And thereto I pledge thee my faith.
I, Margaret, take thee, Frank.
I, Margaret, take thee, Frank.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
From this time forward.
From this time forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
And thereto I pledge thee my faith.
And thereto I pledge thee my faith.
Frank, what token do you offer in pledge of your vows? You take this ring, Frank, and place it on the third finger of the left hand of your bride. Hold it in place and repeat after me. This ring I give.
This ring I give.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of my constant faith.
Of my constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
Margaret, what token do you offer in pledge of your vow? You take this ring, Margaret, and place it on the third finger of the left hand of your groom. Hold it in place and repeat. This ring I give.
This ring I give.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of my constant faith.
Of my constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
Now will you join your right hands together again, please? Forasmuch as Frank and Margaret have consented together in holy wedlock and have pledged their faith each to the other by the authority that is committed unto me, I pronounce them husband and wife. Whom, therefore, God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. Let us pray. Most merciful and gracious God, Bestow upon these thy servants the seal of thine approval and thy fatherly benediction, granting unto them grace to fulfill with pure and steadfast devotion the vow and covenant between them made. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.
What a beautiful moment for Margaret and Frank to remember all their lives. You know, there probably is no happier time in life than when two people become a brand new bride and groom. And we're very pleased to learn that lots of brand new brides watch our program each day. And I have a bit of news for them. But if you're an all settled down married missus with a family to do for, I guess maybe you'd better hear it too. You know, this Bisquick is a pretty unusual product. There just isn't anything else quite like it. For instance, when you go to the store, you know how many different kinds of special mixes you see on the shelves. There's muffin mix and hot roll mix and pancake and waffle mixes, cake mixes, shelf loads of them. But there's only one Bisquick. And with that one wonderful product, you can make practically all the things those other mixes make. Just look. Betty Crocker sends you her very own special can't-miss directions for a whole dozen different things that Bisquick makes. Look at them all. Well, there isn't a meal you serve that Bisquick can't make easier for you and more fun for the family. Good? I'll say good. I'll show you how good. See? Nothing soggy or flat about those dumplings. Somebody reached for the Bisquick. Uh-huh. Good old grandma-style drop biscuits. Or maybe you like your biscuits this way. It's all the same. You just reach for the Bisquick. Yes, even cake. That's Betty Crocker's very latest cake discovery, velvet crumb cake. Takes just one lone egg. You beat it a mere minute and a half, and you know what to reach for. Here, you do it. Reach for the Bisquick. Because Mrs. Bride, Mrs. Mother, for feeding the family, you just can't beat Bisquick. And here come our bride and groom. Congratulations to you, Frank. We've some wedding gifts that are going to bring smiles to your face even bigger than the one you have there marked with lipstick. First of all, it's lovely Queen Bess setting, 12-place settings of the traditional Queen Bess silver, delicate in design and long-lasting.
Excuse me, I think the honeymoon gift should come first.
Looks like a bellboy.
This wonderful Samsonite luggage. Frank, for you, this wonderful Samsonite journey, and of course for you, Margaret, this little train case here and the matching ladies' wardrobe, all in handsome, natural, rawhide finish.
Yes, and no wash-day blues for you, Margaret, because a wonderful Westinghouse laundromat will be doing the work for you. It'll wash, rinse, and dry in one operation, this laundromat will, and you can be sure if it's Westinghouse.
Now from Hudson, makers of the world's number one paper napkins, a charming traditional chafing dish designed by Carol Stupel, plus a full year supply of each of the four wonderful Hudson napkins to dress up your table and cut down your work.
You're going to have this beautiful tap and gas range too. It has the window and the oven door, the divided cooking top, a tell you set time and temperature guide, and just loads of exclusive tap-in features. And to give you loads of simple or fancy cooking suggestions either, Margaret, Betty Crocker wants you to have her cookbook. General Mills wants you to have a good big supply of their many fine products. And we all want you to have a talking motion picture of your wedding day on Bride and Groom that'll be sent to you by General Mills. And now let's talk about your honeymoon. Your plans for your honeymoon begin with this brand new Pontiac Catalina with Pontiac's new dual range hydromatic. Through scenic highways of New York and southern New England, you'll drive to the charming public house in Sturbridge, Massachusetts. The fame of this picturesque inn and its hospitable manager, Mr. Richard Treadway, has spread far and wide, with good reason, too. There's a lovely New England countryside to explore together, and the quaint village of Sturbridge itself is very delightful. After long, happy days outdoors, you'll be ready for the matchless meals which have made the public house one of the most popular inns in all New England. It's a lovely, romantic spot, and we know you'll take back to West Virginia memories of a perfect honeymoon at the public house in Sturbridge. Congratulations again, Frank. Thank you both for sharing your happiness with all of us this wonderful day. And we'll see you again in a moment for your reception. Good luck for a long, happy married life together. Well, you know, when the senior prom queen happens to be class secretary and the football captain happens to be class president, well, obviously there are bound to be a lot of meetings necessary to conduct the class business. When these meetings change from being business and started being personal, we don't know yet. We'll learn tomorrow when we meet this couple and hear their most interesting love story. That's tomorrow at the same time on most of these same CBS stations. Bride and Groom has been presented by Bisquick, the 12-in-1 mix, and Crust Quick, Betty Crocker's Pie Crust Mix.
This is the CBS Television Network.